When I was a kid, I used to love fighting all the time. I used to be a little troublemaker, and my dad's like, listen, you need to get into a gym. I'd know nothing about boxing or MMA or not, and my dad threw me in the gym. And ever since that day, I just fell in love with it. Like, I was in my element where I stopped fighting in the streets. I'd focus my energy in the ring because I realised people who fight in the streets are getting nowhere. They're just going to end up in jail or somewhere stupid. Where I thank my dad till this day for making me go to the gym, because if it weren't for him, I don't think I would have found the gym. And when my dad used to own a sweet shop in Sheffield, top of the hill, my dad's sweet shop, and at the bottom was Prince Nassim's gym. And the only reason why it was so close, that shop was Nassim's brother's gym. Like, we were proper close with them, and I used to like swear going to school, pretend I was sick, and my dad would try and look for me everywhere, and he'd know I'm in the gym just chilling, watching Nassim box. I used to just love it, and like, at the time, I didn't know what boxing was until my dad threw me in the ring to get my head jabbed off everywhere. Then I realised, I love it, I'm going to get my head down and see what I can make about it, because I know I'm suited for the pros, where the amateurs, I enjoyed it, but I couldn't progress as fast because I was a bit like taking my time, where in the amateurs you've got to be fast, pity patty, where in the pros I took my time. I know I can take my time. I just, time will tell, and hopefully you see more of me in the future.
There's a lot of boxers who have been influenced by Prince Nassim Mohammed over the years. You was actually, like you say, going in the gym as a young kid and seeing him coming through. So, I mean, if you was going to get influenced, that was certainly a place to get influenced and a person to influence you. So you've got good memories of that time in being in Sheffield, and obviously you're in Liverpool now. But take us back to that then, and watching the Prince from a young lad. And did you ever speak to him? Did he ever give you advice?
Honest, I never used to really speak to him because I was only small. He used to must look at me and think, what's this little baby doing? He let me phone his dad. Like, when I used to watch him, it was amazing because there'd be loads of people and like be a big girl, and he's just there just punching the bag. And I was thinking to myself, what's inside that bag? And then I realised, someone said to me, it's the heavy bag. Then I just realised within the scene, like, he was cocky. I reckon if he would have listened a bit more, he would have been a legend, where he did become a world champion. His ego and his cockiness didn't let him reach where he wanted to reach. He could have beat Pereira if he really wanted to, but there was a few stories that we heard. We don't know what's the truth, but at the end of the day, I respect Nassim and I thank him for every day, because if it weren't for him or his family, I don't think I would have come into boxing. Because when I first walked into the boxing, I was looking at all these bags thinking, what's this? I was that A big thinking, what's all this? Then I realised when I got older, it's a heavy bag to start punching. And I started seeing people getting pads in that, and I just started falling in love more. And then I realised you got to use your body as a weapon. You can't just box, you got to like defend and move, where just time will tell. Now I'm going to just take it slowly, break it down. Every day I'm in the gym learning. There's not one day where I don't learn. Every day I'm constantly learning. I'm not saying I'm brand new, but it's like I go home and I'm like, wow, did I learn that today? It's crazy. Every day I learn something new, and that's not a lie. It's crazy. I don't know. It's just mad where you go in the ring. Like I say to myself, yeah, I'm going to go in the gym today and practice this. And say to yourself, no, you need to do this more, you're not ready. Then like, I just slow myself down because I want to perfect everything. It's not a joke. You're going in the ring with ATOS gloves. It's a serious game. Like, people need to realise it's not a mess of balls, it's a fight.
What's your style like if no one saw you fight? Have you got any influence of the Prince in your style?
I've got a few videos on the Instagram, but I don't really like posting them. But like, what I like doing, I like to make them miss. Make them miss, because obviously when you make them miss, you can see openings. So I like to counter most of the time, so I'll make them miss, then come back with me own, where an average boxer would just be there coming forward. What I like to do, I'll put my hands down, tease them, and I'll move and counter the shots, where I don't do it to get them angry. It's just, it's a sweet science. It's a mind game. Show them a punch, then move, you know what I mean? Like, that's what I love doing. I like making people miss and pay.
Sounds very much like the Prince to me, that style, so I'm sure you have been influenced by that. Look forward to seeing you going forward, definitely. You're at the Golden Gloves gym here. It's a special gym in the area. It's a very famous gym in British boxing. It's been here for a long time, done a lot for the community, and a lot of fighters have come through here. Wayne Smith is your coach. He's currently taking the mantle of the gym and running it. Great place to be, and you know, there's one thing I always come in here, and all the lads and girls in here say it as well, it's like a big family.
It is. Most gyms you go to, it's like the egos and mad, but this gym, it's like family. You get in, you're part of the family, happy days. It's learned me about to be respectful and to be disciplined, because you can train as much as you want, but what do you do outside the gym? That plays a big role in the boxing game, where you can train hard and you can go home and have a chippy and go and chill with your mates and get high or get drunk, or you go to the gym, train, go home, chill with your family, have an early night, wake up, so eat, sleep, repeat, eat. There's no point going in the gym, training hard, then going out, messing around, no point. You're going to take it serious, come in the gym, get your head down, and you'll see results.
And what are your ambitions? Where do you see yourself taking this?
To be honest, I want to, like, as I said, I'm not in it for the money. I just want to get a few belts. Obviously, when you get a few belts, money comes with it, but I just want to get a few belts. So at the end of the day, I could turn around and say I was number one in the world, because I want to be a life coach when I retire from boxing. So if I've got a world title, I could sit back and say, what? I've done it. So people will be motivated and they'll come see me. Where if I want to be a life coach, no, people will look at me like, who are you? But if I've got a world title or an English title or a British title, they'll be like, he's someone, this kid. It's just the image, really. It's sad to say, but people are brainwashed, aren't they? Like,
what's your influence to be a life coach?
Basically, I like helping people. Like, I'm a PT as well, and I train people in the gym, but I've realised being a life coach, like, you just, some people are just mentally not right in the head. So I tell them, get in the gym, get your anger out. Then when they're nice and calm, I like speaking to them. I just want to help people and make them succeed. I don't think no one's struggling. Just guide them the right way.
That's really good, that's brilliant, yeah. Yeah, I'm sure you're going to go a long way in boxing and in life, Marnie. Thank you very much. All the very best of luck. Nice. I look forward to following the journey with you.
Nice one.
When you know when you're going to make your pro debut.
Appreciate this as well, Chris, thanks.
You're very welcome, thank you. Thank you.
Nice one.
So, pro debut, what have you got in your mind? What sort of date?
Hopefully September or after September, hopefully, I'm aiming.
So the process of your licence is all going through at the moment? Obviously, all these setbacks not help things.
This pandemic slowed everything down, innit?
Yeah. We'll take it for what it is, but the future's bright, and I look forward to seeing that as well. And following the journey. God bless you.
Thank you very much.
Speak to you soon.
Nice one.